Hey guys, Palmetto Patriot 1 here. This is our very first video. The discussion for tonight is going to be battle rifles, defensive rifles, go-to rifles, fighting rifles. Guys, these are terms that's just all over the internet. You can look them up, and we're going to talk about those terms and how they apply. We're also going to discuss the rifle that I would have to say is my go-to rifle in case I found myself to where I would have to use a defensive posture or a defensive mode to protect me, my family, my neighbors, what have you. So guys, stay tuned, hold tight, and we're gonna get this review on the road.
I lift my ball chain behind me, every burden, every weight. I change my name to freedom. Stood up to my oppressors, shook the shackles off my hands. I'm going down to the promised land. I'm dusting off the desert, I'm silencing my doubt. The one who goes before me is the one who leads me out. The fire in the darkness, footprints in the sand. I'm going down to the promised land.
What do you consider a battle rifle? I know there's a lot of videos out there on YouTube discussing that topic. A lot of information on the internet discussing topics as far as battle rifles, what they should be. This is my battle rifle, and first things first, we'll check it. I'll center forward. We'll pull her back out. She is clear. And guys, this is a DTI 16 inch, and that's a Delton Arms 16 inch AR. They call it the DTI 15. Shoots the 5.56 caliber or the 223. Things that I think characteristics the rifle should have if it's going to be considered a battle rifle. I think that number one, and this is really don't have anything to do with the rifle, but the individual behind the rifle. You need to have training, guys. Know how to function that rifle under stress. Do you some push-ups and go out and shoot. Just standing there shooting a stationary target and not moving is not good training. If you're just trying to zero in a sight, yeah, that's fine. You're trying to teach somebody new to the firearms of how to shoot and carry trigger pull and things of that nature. That's excellent. But if you're going to train for a battle situation or a realistic situation, you need to add some stress levels to it, because your heart rate changes, the way you think changes. Unless you have training instilled and you have muscle memory developed and you know your rifle like the back of your hand, chances are you're going to come out of that situation pretty good. If you don't, it's going to mess you up. Instructors that taught me and what I passed on to my students was the biggest thing was detail. It's not the big stuff that messes up and causes us to fail. It's the small, detailed stuff. And you miss that detailed stuff because you're either competing with the guys in the class sitting beside you, and you're worried about me finishing before him, and you're not paying attention to that detail. Or you're going so fast, and you're thinking so far ahead that you miss that small detail, and you end up failing in the end. So that's the main thing, especially if you get caught into a gun fight, for God's sakes. I hope it don't happen. But if you ever get caught in a position where you had to use this rifle to defend yourself, defend your family, or defend your community, or whatever you had to do, it's that small detail stuff. But if you develop muscle memory and you train, that's going to limit that chances of you failing. There's some other things that you can add to that, like features. These are the Legos. They make parts out there that can help you as far as be a little bit faster to help you when you run your hands or your fingers across the controls. You have different feels. You can feel, oh, I know what that is, or I know what this is, and I know what that does, if you had training on it. But when you get these parts, just because you put them on, I don't mean they're always going to work. You got to train with them. You got to know. This is my battle rifle. Magpul furniture. Got the mode, 6-position stop. Got the Magpul sling adapter. Reason I chose this adapter is because if you ever get into a situation to where you had to go from strong side to weak side, the abilities of that sling moving side to side, that helps out tremendously and not hindering you from doing your job, not taking your focus on what you need to be doing. Now you're worried about choking yourself out. So while you're trying to get that untangled, the bad guy's sending bullets down your way. So that's a easy fix to kind of build your confidence a little bit better and have one less thing you have to worry about. It has the Magpul mow grip with a little compartment in the bottom where you can keep your spare batteries, spare bolt, that type things inside there in an emergency if you needed it to help you maintain your rifle and keep it in combat. This one is equipped with a ambidextrous safety selector, and I really enjoy that safety selector, having it on either side, so if anything were to happen with my strong arm, I could go to weak side and no problems. I had the bad device, battery assisted device. What it does is it pulls the bolt back, locks it back. Instead of you having to use both hands, I can put that gun back in the battery, or that rifle back in the battery, and be right back on the rifle again. So that's one of the best tools. And if you needed to send it forward, you just tap here. That could send it forward, or you can traditionally hit it on the back plate and just send the bolt. I do have the Magpul trigger guard, the little plastic trigger guard. That works out good if a gloved hand, especially now it's cold outside. You're gonna probably have gloves on if you're gonna be out there for a long period of time, and being able to get that gloved hand inside that trigger guard without having any problems. I do have the Badger extension on my charging handle. I'm looking maybe to change this charging handle out and go with a ambidextrous, which would pretty much complete this rifle as far as ambi-wise. More ambidextrous equipment and accessories I put on this rifle, the better off it is for me in case something were to happen. I mean, I may not even use that side of it, but I will train with it just to make sure that I got some efficiency with it. So that's one of the main things, is make sure you're efficient with all the equipment on your rifle. The sling here is a Magpul Generation 1. The ones they came out with had the old gator clips that worked on them, had the little slide wheel that locked them in place. So it had I got the front mount for the sling. It's a Magpul also. So the sling is capable of being emergency rip away. That's why I put this little tether on here. So all that is a little braided up paracord I put on there, just in case you get into a jam to where you need to get that sling off of you in a hurry. And you just pull that little paracord and that'll release the sling. I had the Magpul AFG front hand stop. That kind of gives me a mark to where I need my rifle to be at, out in front of me. Works out well. And I'm mounting my flashlight. This is a Streamlight Polytech, to where I can control that flashlight with my thumb while I'm engaged onto the rifle. So it works out well. That's a Phoenix ALG Generation 1 flashlight holder for pretty much any type of flashlight. This compensator shocked me. I got it for just thought it looked cool, and I thought it might work better than with the birdcage. It comes with the standard with the ARs, and picked this up at a gun show for $20. Screwed it on there, timed it. And when I say timing, I mean, you know, it's got small port holes at the top. Those need to be at your 12 o'clock, straight up and down. If you're holding your rifle in your hand, those little ports need to be straight up and down. And the big gills, or the big side slashes in the compensator, they need to be to your 3 o'clock and your 9 o'clock, out to your right and left. So you need to make sure that's timed right. If not, you turn it the other way, it's going to blow dirt in your eye, and it's going to probably blow dirt on somebody else. So just be aware of it. This little compensator for $20, it's some kind of Chinese made, and it's got a little weight to it, but shooting it, I shot probably 500 rounds through this, and it's held up excellent. It does what it's supposed to do. It takes out all the muzzle rise. Recoil, 5.56 to me doesn't have a whole lot of recoil. But what little recoil it did have, it probably cut that in half. It's like shooting a 22, basically. It's very similar to shooting a 22. It's just a louder noise. That little booger there works excellent. So that's worth the money. I can't wait till another gun show when I find that table where that guy's got these muzzle brakes, and I'm going to get me about two or three more of those. So those work real well. Magpul Imbus front sight, and that works well. Is I have a ambidextrous magazine catch. So to release the magazine, traditionally you have your magazine release button here, push it and magazine falls out. Magazine is in place. This one also has a magazine, ambidextrous magazine release on the opposite side. It's where your magazine catch bar goes through. It's usually flush on your AR. This one actually dimples out some, so it sticks out a little bit. And if you push it, or on a ditch in here, your magazine's released. So it will drop the magazine on either side. And that's a good little tool. And you gotta practice with it to get it going. But you get that magazine in there, and you can practice with it on both sides. Put another one in. Get that working for you. And that's a good little tool. Guys, if you'll pay attention to the handguard, this is made in China. But if you're familiar with the UGT Pro, Slimline Pro, that's what it feels like, because I do have a UGT Slimline Pro on my Rock River rifles, but it feels just like that. It's real small, real lightweight, fits real good in the palm of the hand. I don't have a big hand, so it fits real well in the palm of the hand. And it's lightweight, and it's a 15-incher on a 16-inch barrel, so that'll let you see. It's about maybe an inch from the threads where the compensator screws in, and when you put this compensator on, depending on how long or how tall that compensator is, you're looking at probably maybe 3 inches, 2.5, 3 inches sticking out past the rail. I like that. I think it looks sexy, right? And I think it operates, man, it gives you more real estate to get way out there on that rifle. To get you out there looking. So I mean, that thing works nice. $58 or $54, I believe it was. It's less than $60, I know. If you notice those bungees, I seen that on YouTube where there's an NRA channel was doing a video, or he made a video on one of those. I cannot remember the name of that rifle. It's a high dollar AR. $5,000-$6,000 AR, and it had these bungees, and I thought that was pretty cool. I looked at that and I was like, man, I got some bungee in the shop. I'm just gonna go ahead and weave that through there. That looks pretty cool. It looks cool to me. It actually gives you a little bit, somewhat of a little grip, a little texture to the rifle when you're holding it, but it serves a purpose. So if you're using, say, a rail system light with a pressure switch, and you have to run those wires, you really don't want to run those wires through those key mod holes next to that barrel, because if you're firing a lot of rounds in a short period of time, that barrel's going to get hot, and you don't want it to melt the wiring harnesses or the wires that's feeding to your pressure switch, because if you do, you're going to damage that. Now you're going to have to buy new wires, and a lot of times, if you know the headache, if you're running a budget flashlight, it's hard as hell to find replacement pressure switch wires or that assembly for that particular flashlight. So if you would, instead of doing that, if you ran your light and it had a wire on the back, you could run your wires through these little bungees all the way down to where you're going to place your pressure switch at, so to keep it out from that barrel. That's the reason for the bungees. I think it looks cool. Sets the rifle off a little bit better. Gives it that little cool factor to it. But it does work. It does have a purpose, and it is not just aesthetics. It does work for a purpose. It does have a function. So guys, that's my philosophy on a battle rifle. Hope you enjoyed the video. If you do, please subscribe. If you're new to guns, please subscribe. Guys, looking forward to do more videos, more reviews. This is Palmetto Patriot 1. Guys, you stay warm out there. God bless. And remember, guys, you are your brother's keeper. Palmetto Patriot 1, we're going to be out.